All right, we're here at the streets of Willow Springs in Rosemont, California for our 600 shootout. New GSXR 600 against our class champion from 2009, Kawasaki ZX6R, the excellent track-worthy Yamaha R6, and Honda's CBR600RR that did so well on the street. We're gonna tear them around with our friends at Track Experience Track Days, and we're gonna see which one works best on the track.
Dressed all casual amongst all these hard workers here. This motorcycle job business is so easy. Anyway, look what we got here. Kawasaki ZX6R, returning Supersport class champ from Motorcycle.com. It's returning this year, but in the face of some new competition. However, we're talking about a lot of the good things we really enjoyed about this from before. Key among that is its incredible motor. It feels like it has more on top than anything at some points. I don't know what you thought, Troy.
More on top, pretty darn good mid-range too. Yeah. I mean, everywhere you want it, it's there. So it's hard to fault this engine.
We love this motor, and another thing that got universal praise was its front brakes. They're not Brembos or something fancy, but we all really think these are some of the class's best, even in face of some new Brembos from Suzuki.
Okay, newest bike in the class, 2011 Gixxer 6er. My last trip on this wasn't too long ago at its US launch at Barber. Came away liking a lot of things about it, primarily its ergonomic package and its handling. It has an improved mid-range and a little more power up top. But Troy and Kevin have just ridden it for the first time today, so I'm curious to hear what they have to say about it.
Well, for me, my initial reaction was similar to the Honda. I hop on the Suzuki and it feels typical Suzuki, which is, for me, I really dig the ergonomic package on this motorcycle, and so I felt at home on this bike straight away. Two turns, and I was off to the races again. In my opinion, this 600 from Suzuki has taken all the good points of the previous model and made them better. Overall, really good package.
My last session of the day was on the GSXR, and I was really impressed. When I'm trying to find out all the flaws on a bike, and I'm running out of things to question, that's a good sign. Great chassis, steers quite quick, still remains stable, new Brembo monoblock brakes, adjustable foot pegs too, which comes in handy for adjusting the ergos to your particular body style, new dashboard, which is actually quite attractive, and a beautiful frame and swing arm color. I think the best GSXR 600 we've ridden in a long time.
To date.
All right, the Yamaha YZF R6, same basic motorcycle since 2008. Basically what, you know, this bike is all about is the racetrack. I mean, all the power is up top, really nothing or very little down low. It is aging a bit, you can, especially in this last year, we would like to see some revisions to it. But, you know, all in all, not a bad motorcycle if these other ones weren't in the picture.
My first trip out on the R6 today, that's something that struck me right away is that it's still has that screamer engine. But what struck me about the R6 is that it's a racer's motorcycle. I understand why so many club racers choose the R6, because it performs well where you kind of wrap the throttle out in that element. When you're going that fast and you're diving into the turns, the front end is well planted, communicates a lot of the track back to the rider, so it's confident, but it's very much carved from racetrack history.
Yeah, this is a great track weapon, but even here on the racetrack, we noticed that pulling out of some of the corners, when the gearing's not maximized for each corner, that these other motorcycles pull a little harder if you let the revs drop too far down. So it's still one of the prettiest bikes in the class, especially this new paint scheme this year. I think it looks really sharp, and it's easy to see why somebody would be attracted to this bike. Honda CBR600RR, this came out, it's the oldest bike in the group. 2007 it debuted, and we immediately liked it. Lightest bike in the class then, and still the most nimble, agile bike of this group. One of the places where this CBR falls a bit short, I think, especially at the racetrack, is up top. In 2009, we found out that to meet noise emissions regulations, Honda trimmed a bit of power off the top, and we can really notice it here at the racetrack.
However, that being said, it still has a potent and meaty mid-range, excellent fueling, very easy to modulate throttling all the way around the track, and especially in a bumpy course like the Streets of Willow, that's very important. And what goes along with that is a lot of us, I know me and Pete, maybe you too, Kevin, but we hopped on this thing, and within two turns, we instantly felt like this was our motorcycle, like we've been riding it forever, and no need to get comfortable with the controls, the ergonomics, nothing. And so that was a big, big positive point in my opinion.
So at the end of a day at Streets of Willow on the 600s, got a Yamaha, it's a great track bike, but its motor doesn't quite pull as hard as the other ones. Over here we got the CBR600, it's the most agile and is a great motorcycle, but it doesn't pull as hard on top as these two bikes up front. The class champion, returning class champion, ZX, that's one of our favorites here, and lots of good things to say about it, and they all start with motor. And the new GSXR, great all-around package, versatile, and almost no faults at all. So to see the winner of our 600 track shootout, go to Motorcycle.com and stay tuned for our street shootout with these same four bikes.